beach house today, which means I have a lot to do. Can you tell by my outfit that I am headed to the beach? So I have a lot to meal prep before we leave, because the last thing that I wanna do when I'm on vacation, really it's not a vacation when you go with kids, it's more like a trip. Have you seen the meme? It's like, when you go on vacation with kids, you're really just parenting in a new environment or something like that. It's funnier than that, but whatever, I butcher everything. Anyway, so today I have a few things that I wanna make to make life smooth in the salty air. I plan on making pecan pie bars just as a treat. You know, just at the end of the day, middle of the day, morning of the day. Who doesn't want a good treat on the beach? However, I planned on making those, but I don't have any light brown sugar, but I do know Alex needs to go out and get some chlorine before we leave. So maybe when he's out, he can stop by and get me some brown sugar. You think they sell that at the pool store? No? Okay. But the main thing I want to make is the egg scramble. It's just eggs with a bunch of veggies, and it just makes me feel like I'm eating something healthy, because it is healthy. I also plan on making a bunch of chicken marinades, not only for when we're there, because they have grills there, and it's just like the best to not have to cook a bunch of dinner and send Alex down to the grills and be like, here you go, here's the chicken, go grill it, you know? So I found a lot of chicken marinades, so I'm going to share more than just, I think we're there for 3 or 4 nights, but I'm probably gonna make way more, so when we come home, they're ready. I can also throw them in the freezer and they're good to go. I wanna make some salads, maybe energy balls, and I bought stuff to make sandwiches and hamburgers. Oh, I have a grocery haul. I'll share that with you at the end. I already went grocery shopping for all my crap, but I'll show you the full haul at the end so you can see what we're eating that I don't have to prep. Okay, anyway, let's get this party going. I need to scramble some eggs. Oh, I forgot I bought some beef, so I might make some chili, prep some chili. I haven't decided yet. We'll see how much time I have. Oh, I also made an Oreo dessert. It's Oreo Deluxe. It has cookie dough in it and Oreos. It is the best. I made that a couple vlogs ago, so I'll share that with you. But the first, oh, I'm also gonna cut up some fruit today. I don't think I mentioned that. Some fruit I've got to cut up, because fresh fruit on the beach, the best.
Simply the best.
The first thing I'm gonna do is cook some potatoes in the microwave. I'm trying to remember if I cut them before I put them in the microwave or before I cook them on the stovetop. I'm trying to think, because if I cut them after I cook them in the microwave, then they're gonna be so hot to touch, and but you know what? I think that's what I do. Throw them in the microwave, they'll be fine. And while that is cooking, I'm going to cut up my bell peppers and my jalapeno. And did you know that there are two types of peppers? Well, that's a bad example. There's normally one with like 3 feet. This has one, this has two. I've never heard of those. Normally it's 3 or 4, and this is a female, and apparently they're sweeter because we're the sweetest. I know everyone has their own way of cutting and seeding peppers, but I find that this is like the least amount of waste, where I just pull out the seed. This goes without saying, but you can use any type of vegetable that you want. Let me get some gloves. Zucchini would be really good in this, but last time I made this, well, not last time I made it, but last time I made it with a full jalapeno with the seeds, oh my gosh, I could barely eat it. It was so painful. So call me a wimp, I don't care, but I'm taking the seeds and the veins out. Because really, I think someone told me the heat stays with the membranes, because they're insane and they got no brains. I do like to keep a little bit of the seeds, because obviously as a jalapeno, I like a little bit of spice, but too much, you know, it's unbearable. It becomes unenjoyable to eat, and you know, I'm just trying to enjoy my breakfast on the beach. I think that's it. Okay. Oh, an onion. Yeah, thank you for reminding me. We've got an onion here. Let's give this the old chippity chop. Don't stop a rockin'. I need a garbage bowl. You know, Rachel Ray always has a garbage bowl. Rachel Ray is subsequently the person who taught me how to peel and cut an onion. But I recently watched her, and she doesn't cut it in the middle anymore. Which I'm not sure she ever did, but Gordon Ramsay does, so it's like, do what you want. Just want little pieces, you know? And the reason why she doesn't cut it in the middle and why you really don't have to is because they're already in teeny tiny pieces, but I find once you reach the end, then the pieces get a little clumpy. So just for good measure, I give it the one pass. One through. And that's what we do on Semi Homemade with Kimberly Whisk. Once I have all my veggies chopped, I'm going to cook them on the stovetop in just a little bit of oil. And then I'm also going to cook my eggs at the same time. I'll get the big Bertha. I'm just gonna throw all the veggies in. Hopefully they all fit. There's still more. I guess I need a bigger cutting board. And then I just season it up pretty simple with some salt and pepper. Add whatever you like, but apparently that's what I like. And give it a little mix. Doesn't this just make you want to eat some veggies? Moving on to the scrambled egg portion. Nothing super special if you know the secret hack to make amazing scrambled eggs. I'm gonna crack, I don't know, 12 to 18 eggs in here. Okay, here's the hack you've all been waiting for. If you want your eggs super duper fluffy, like restaurant quality, like Cracker Barrel, you just add a little bit of heavy whipping cream, or half and half if you have that. Then you know how we season every layer, just a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. Give it a nice whisk. I normally don't add anything to my eggs, and I just whisk them really well to get them nice and aerated and fluffy, and that works too. I almost forgot, I'm having a lot of brain farts. I am going to add some sausage. You can also do bacon if that's your thing, but I just think this gives it so much flavor. I'll do a whole pound. I mean, what am I gonna do with the rest of this half a pound in my fridge? Who knows? So I'm just gonna cook it all up. It's gonna be the look. Okay, the peppers are done. I'm just gonna put them all in here. Sausage is also done, so I'm gonna plop that in here too. There's a lot of steps to this, which is why I don't always make it very often. And I'm just over here cutting up potatoes without a cutting board. Don't judge me, it's my countertop, you know what I mean? Also, the potatoes are stinking hot. Once I have a fair amount of potatoes cooked up, I'm using the same pot I cooked the sausage in. There's hardly any sausage oil, so I'm using my own oil. I'm using the olive oil. There's kids all around me. I'm adding in the potatoes. Just so they get a nice little crunch on them. As with everything else, a little bit of salt and pepper. Oh my God. Okay, I forgot to throw the jalapenos in, so I'm cooking them right now. And oh my gosh, the smell. I'm just gonna throw the potatoes in. Now the jalapenos go in too. Man, I'll tell you what, every time I make this, I think, whoa, when is it over? Because there are so many steps, but every time I eat it, I'm like, yep, that's why, it's delicious. I'm going to cook the eggs now. You can add butter, but I'm going to add oil because apparently it's my blood. You guys know, just scramble these up and add it to the bowl, low and slow. And the final touch, we add the eggs in. I tell you what, you're never gonna see anything like this on Pinterest. Well, maybe you will. I don't know. Looks pretty good to me. I normally add spinach, but this is what happens when you don't make an extensive grocery list. I might have some in my freezer. I'm just over this and don't feel like doing anything else to it, so we're gonna move on to the marinades. Okay, the place is getting crazy. I'm going to move on to the marinades. And typically when I do marinades, I put them in a bowl or something that I don't have to throw away, but since we're going to the beach house, I'm gonna be freezing some of these. I figure I'll just use Ziploc bags. Don't forget to hydrate, it purifies the soul. One marinade at a time here. I'm testing out a whole bunch. Okay, so apparently there are four major components when it comes to a marinade. And those components are fat, acid, salt, and flavor. Okay, so this first one I'm gonna throw together is, I found a blog with a ton of marinade ideas, and this is apparently her favorite. So it's a half a cup of oil, half a cup of honey. If you put the oil in before the honey, it slides out like butter. Half a cup of soy sauce. I use Coco Aminos. It's a soy-free version, and I just think it tastes better and it's healthier for you. And then one tablespoon of garlic. Isn't there a garlic hack? Yeah, there is a garlic hack. All right, hold on, check this out.
Okay, I've only done this once before on my Instagram, but so I don't know if I really remember. I think you cut the end off, the root, like this, and they all just fall apart. Look at that. It works. It really, really works. So that's pretty cool. Also kind of makes a mess. Some people have this really cool garlic roller where it like peels off the skin. Oh, look. I don't need to buy a gadget. I can just use my hands. That's pretty cool, right? So let's try that again. Well, maybe it doesn't. All right, maybe I need to buy the gadget. Okay, well, I'm gonna spend 45 minutes peeling this garlic, unless you have, you know, the pre-made garlic, but I always say this tastes 100 times better than that, but if you're going for a convenience, you know, you go ahead and use whatever you need to. If you don't have fresh garlic in your garden, okay, that's good for now. Okay, finally minced it all up. You add a tablespoon of garlic, and now that I'm reading it, it might just be garlic powder. I don't know. Either way, this will give you a little more flavor. That's it for this one. Then you just add in your chicken or whatever meat you're marinating. I add chicken thighs because they're nice and juicy and delicious. You can use whatever you want. And give it a mix and let that marinate, I don't know, at least an hour. It's gonna be days for us. Okay, since we shared her favorite, next thing to do is to share my favorite marinade. It is super simple. We have the oil and the flavor in one here with the Italian dressing. I always use this Olive Garden Italian dressing, mostly because it's what I have and love, but I'm sure normal dressing would be fine. It's 8 ounces, so that's a cup. And then a half a cup of honey.
What else?
Ooh, my favorite. And you need a quarter cup of lime juice. And I just roll my limes just to try to break up the insides and really get those juices flowing. I have this juicer, but I don't feel like washing it. So I'm just going to cut into the limes. They don't have seeds, right? Oh my gosh. Fresh lime juice is a true gift. I just pierce it with a fork to get all of the lovely juice out of it because my fingers hurt. And I also just throw the lime straight in there. Don't worry, I washed them. I think we can get away with just 2 limes for a quarter cup because these are pretty juicy. A quarter cup is just 4 tablespoons. So I think we're good. Oh my gosh. I say it every time, but if I could just rub it, ooh, and smell like lime juice all day, I totally would. Do they have a perfume that's just lime? Well, I guess essential oils you can just rub right there. Okay, juicy juice. And that's it. This is the whole marinade. Super simple, right? And I'm not kidding when I tell you it is super delicious. And then you add the chicken. Again, I have chicken thighs. And so many people told me, ooh, I need to wash, that they just use Italian dressing as a marinade, and it is fantastic. So if you don't have all this extra stuff, or you don't want to add it, or you just, I don't know, want to try Italian dressing, try that. Let me know how it is. Just gonna zhuzh it around, get all that honey incorporated. I mean, in my opinion, the limes just really elevate the dish, and you know that's what I'm all about. I just spent 10,000 hours looking for curry paste, couldn't find it, but I found some, nope, I was looking for curry powder, found some red curry paste, I think this will work. Let's whip together our next one, which is called chicken. I just wrote down chicken. Apparently it's a good one. Half a cup of soy sauce. Or Coco Aminos, you know my jam.
Ah, I cannot get it open.
A quarter cup of sweet chili sauce. 2 tablespoons of oil. At this point in the game, I have rid of my measuring cups, apparently. 1 teaspoon of curry powder. Ooh. But I couldn't find it. I have paste, so that'll be good. And you know what? I'm just gonna use the rest of the jar. Let's give it a nice zing. And some green onions. 2 tablespoons. I'm just gonna give these a nice little chop. Green onions add so much flavor to everything. Is that 2 tablespoons? Let's just do the whole thing. The more the merrier is what I always say. Not the root. Okay, we're gonna add the green onions right in there. Is that it? Green onion. And then the main ingredient. And then the chicken goes in. Marinades are so easy to whip together, but they pack such a punch, don't they? I give this a nice hug, a nice little massage. Hey, how you doing?
Okay, the next one we're gonna throw together is a balsamic. Let's just call it that. So 16 ounces of Italian seasoning. I'm just gonna use 1 cup. I don't care what's in there. Is 1 cup 8 ounces? Now I have myself questioning. How many ounces is in 1 cup? Yeah, I was right. Google always has my back. I'm gonna hydrate because I need to purify my soul. Okay, it calls for 16 ounces of Italian dressing. I'm not gonna do it. Also calls for 1/4 cup of balsamic vinegar. And I was reading, it's hooked on phonics, worked for me. This is called Tuscan chicken. 1/4 cup of balsamic, I have glaze. It actually calls for balsamic vinegar. Use what you have, right? 1/8 cup of honey. Good, maybe a little more. Teaspoon of dried rosemary. You guys, guess what I'm fresh out of from my garden? Rosemary, but guess what I have? Just a little bit left over of Italian seasoning. So I'm gonna use about 1 tablespoon of that. And then some pepper, easy enough, right? And at this point in the game, I'm going to crack into some chicken breasts that I bought in the frozen section. Cost me an arm and a leg. I'm gonna throw like 3 in here. A 1? Maybe just 2. These are huge. These are huge. I'm gonna do 2. Give this a nice mix. Tuscan chicken. It's looking okay. Okay, this one I'm super excited about. I probably should be labeling these bags, but we've gone too far at this point. It'll be a surprise whenever we make dinner. What are we eating? Chicken. This one is called lemon chicken, so we need 2 of lemons. 1/4 cup of oil. It's about good. 2 cloves of garlic.
So that's about good. 3 tablespoons of lemon juice. And I feel like we could really add the zest in here too. But like, who has time to zest it, you know? So let's just go in with the juice. Oh, seeds. Okay, that's where this thing comes in handy. Okay, 3 tablespoons lemon juice, looking good. And just for fun and presentation, I'm gonna cut this one up just to add the flavor, you know? Oh, it smells so good. Oh,
here's the kicker for this one.
Some fresh dill straight from my garden. Guys, my garden is thriving. Dill, dill is one of my favorite herbs. We don't use it enough, that's my... It's so pretty, I don't even want to cut it. Well, do I need to cut it? Probably not, but I'm gonna give it a chop anyway. Oh my word, yeah, cut it. It really like extracts all of the flavors and scents. I love dill on salmon. My mouth is salivating, it's so good. Add it right in here. Oh man, that's good stuff. Kind of smells like grass. So. 1/2 tablespoon of rice wine vinegar. This stuff is heavy duty. 2 teaspoons of honey for a touch of sweetness. Can you see inside this bag? It just looks like magic. A little more, why not? And then a little bit of salt. Okay, and then you add the chicken. Ooh, this one's gonna be good, I feel it. And then you guys know the deal by now. The dill, you guys know the dill? You just give it a nice little mix.
You just give it a nice little mix.
Doesn't get any easier than this. Well, I guess takeout, but it's a little more expensive.
Okay, the last marinade that I'm gonna do, because I have run out of chicken, but I feel like that's a lot. Where's my knife? Is a pineapple chicken. Super simple, pretty self-explanatory. I also have this pineapple that I need to cut anyway for bakey. So I'm just gonna use my pineapple corer and cut it. You know what? I never thought I would use this thing as much as I actually do. I feel like I'm cutting a pineapple twice a week for my kids. And it is that simple. Okay, here's a little bowl. I'm gonna put it on you.
It's coming closer. Tony Danza.
Hold me closer, Tony Danza. There it is.
Hold on, let's see if we can transfer it. Boom. For the marinade, I need 1/2 cup of pineapple juice. Hopefully I can take some from here. Here's my bag. 1/2 cup. I feel like I could just squeeze the pineapple. Is this how they get pineapple juice? This is how they do it in the big leagues. And then whatever's left in here, I'm just gonna get it all from the insides here. Pretty sure this is a technical way of doing things. No one on Food Network is talking about this. I'm gonna grab a handful of pineapple, throw it in. And then half a cup of oil. All right, this one seems really simple. I kind of think it begs for more. Just a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. I thought I had one that needed orange zest. Do pineapple and orange go together? Oh, I also had one that calls for this. Kinder's Buttery Steakhouse. It's one of my favorite seasonings of all time. But we're gonna have to make that one night for dinner because I don't know what else goes in it. All right, I'm gonna add a couple of chicken breasts. Doesn't look like much, but I wonder if it's gonna be our favorite. Here they are all complete. Don't they look nice and pretty? I should label them since it's like fresh in my mind and we'll see if I actually do it. But for now they look good. I can kind of tell which one is which, you know? Okay, I'm gonna cut up some fruit now. I looked for a watermelon yesterday. They didn't have one. How can it be the middle of summer and a grocery store not sell a watermelon? I don't know, it's blasphemy. I should file a grievance. I do have a melon. Some mangoes, grapes, and strawberries. Anything else? Maybe. I always get a lot of questions about the Dr. Bronner soap. It does not leave a weird taste, and it is good for washing fruits and vegetables. I believe a child got into these grapes last night, so there's about half as many as I bought, but they are nice and crispy, so I'll just wash the rest. I should have bought double.
I cannot believe the whole video, the whole time I was meal planning, meal prepping, all that good stuff in my mind, I could not stop thinking about that one line from the movie Never Been Kissed, which is one of my absolute favorite movies of all time. It's when she's at the prom, you know, she's not Josie Grossy anymore. So she's finally at this prom and she meets up with her cool teacher, Sam Coulson. And I'm going into way too much detail, but essentially she says, "You can't promenade alone." And that's how I feel with you. Thanks for, thanks for making all these marinades with me, because I can't marinade alone. Okay, that's too much. I'm gonna play a song. It's called Get Up Again. Okay, you bag of bones. Why don't you just get up?
Aren't you tired of the drama? You use your words like they are knives. I don't need that type of drama. And trying to be tough all the dang time. To make yourself feel better by taking me down. Once I fell, but now I'm strong, I'm ready for the rematch. Shoot me down, don't you know I get up? Yeah, baby, I will fight. No, there ain't nothing stopping me. I'm bulletproof, I won't fall. I'm bulletproof, go on and shoot me down. I will always get up again. You're looking at me so cold. Get over yourself, are you for real?
Okay, now I'm gonna whip up some energy balls. You guys have seen me make them before, probably, but there's a reason why I make them so often, and that reason is because they're delicious. They're a staple, my kids love them. It's full of healthy ingredients, but also it feels like a treat. 2 cups of oats, going from memory. I feel like I never really remember how to make these, but they always come out just fine. 1 cup of flaxseed meal, and this is full of omegas, and you don't need your measurements to be precise if you saw any of that. The original recipe I shared a ton, and I'll try to get a clip of it for you here, but I deviate from most of those measurements. About an eighth of a cup to a quarter cup of chia seed. These are really good for you too. We don't eat them as much as we should. And then some coconut flakes. I think it's 1 1/3 cup. Oop, let's just do that. And I use unsweetened organic That's how I live my life. It's a joke, I don't. I mean, they are, but I don't live my life that way. 2/3 cup agave nectar. And I thought we were out of peanut butter, but thank goodness for overstock. And then I just do 1 cup of peanut butter. 2 or 3 really hearty spoonfuls. Am I gonna mix this by hand? What am I doing? And then I add very little chocolate chips. I'd say like 2 tablespoons. Because it doesn't need that much. Maybe a little more than that. All right, that's good. The recipe calls, in my opinion, for way, way, way too many chocolate chips. You already have the agave in there and the coconut giving it a little sweetness. But the chocolate chips do add a little bit. Well, I guess I'm mixing it by hand. This is the first time I've done this in, I don't know, since I bought my KitchenAid. Try to get, my last workout in for my summertime bod, beach bod. Here it is. It takes longer to get all the ingredients out than it does to whip it together. This is like a beach staple for us. Really, it's like an everyday staple. You found a rock? Ooh, a rock. Wow. And then you can just roll it into balls. I like to put it in the freezer before I roll it into balls because it just helps it firm up a little bit. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm moving on to the salads. I didn't even think I would have time for this, but well, really I don't, but it's like, what is time? Okay, kids are going crazy, but we're just gonna truck along, okay? I have one head. Did I say something about kids? About 4 minutes of me talking. Okay, anyway, one heart, romaine heart. Just chop it up. You know, I like to use my salad spinner and wash everything, so there's that. I like the taste of dirt, okay? Judge me all you want. I've never had a problem with it. I have this leftover bell pepper. I don't know how it escaped me, but it did, so I'm gonna chop this right in there too. That'll be nice and refreshing. A little bit here, a little bit there. All right, and then I like to throw in some red onion, just a little bit, just to give it a little pizzazz, you know, a little zing. Just chop it into really small pieces. This is actually a lot of red onion. I'm not gonna use all of that. That's a little overkill. It's a little crazy. Everyone on the beach is gonna smell my breath. What happened to my garbage bowl? Okay, and then a whole cucumber. Let's do, like, what am I gonna do with the rest of this? I don't know, maybe cucumbers smell so good. That's why that cucumber candle scent was just so popular back in the day. Cucumbers really do smell delicious. I just chop it up all the way. And I divvy it up between the bowls. Just so refreshing, right? And that's it. Nope, it's not. I've been saving this feta cheese for quite a while. It says it expires on November 24th, which seems a little sketchy to me. But it smells fine and I'm just gonna roll with it. So I guess I'm just gonna, I don't know, take a hunk of chunk, a couple of hunk of chunks, and crumble it myself. Ooh, this is satisfying and delightful. I always like to buy those pre-made salads, but they are so dang expensive. I buy these salad bowls. They come in a very, very huge pack, but they're great for parties and like if you want to pre-make salads. And I pre-make my salads all the time and I just wash the bowls and I keep them. And I reuse them over and over and over again. So if you're worried about that, don't be. Also, I cloth diaper, so in your face. Take a look at these salads. Are you drooling? Are your salivary glands working? The last thing I do is I grab a little container, those plastic containers. I have to find them. I can't remember where I put them. It's been a while since I pre-made salads. And then I put some Olive Garden dressing in there. Ooh, full chef's kiss. This is my favorite salad I make always, always, and forever. Always and forever. Because I love technology. Anyone? Okay, that is it for the meal prep. I will share with you the grocery haul. Let's just do it now.
So here's the grocery haul as a whole. Let's start over here by the healthy stuff, okay? We've got some veggies, some citrus for the marinades, mostly for the marinades. Well, I think 100% for the marinades. Delicious, you guys know, add citrus or fresh herbs to any dish and it completely elevates it to another dimension, okay, to the next dimension. I also grabbed a jalapeno, that's for the egg scramble, red onion, and cucumber is for my salads. I grabbed some green onions. I only need like a tablespoon of them, but I love cutting them up fresh and then sprinkling them over literally any dish I make because it brings me to another dimension. I also grabbed a pineapple. I'm gonna extract the juice from that one for a marinade, and then also eat the pineapple. Just, you know, eat the pineapple. I grabbed some bell peppers for a dish I like to make. It's sausage, bell pepper for the green ones, bell peppers and onions. It's like mashed up sausage, like ground sausage, so delicious. And then the colored peppers I got for the egg scramble. Spring mix, okay, so the other day I went to IKEA. If you saw that IKEA shop with me slash Target shop with me slash, I don't know, it was a vlog style like what I did that day. But in their sandwich, they had a spring mix. Oh my God, I just felt so fancy eating it. I thought I have to recreate that.
Wow.
And then I grabbed some grapes to munch on, some lettuce, romaine hearts to make my salads. If you guys think, oh, Kim, you did such a great job, only one bag of chips. Let me show you my skeletons. My demons over here have three more bags. That's the junk food section. We'll get there. I grabbed a couple cartons of strawberries. They looked really good. And if you saw my latest vlog, maybe not my latest, it was a house tour, an amazing house tour. But then at the end of that, I made such a decadent dessert that we're also bringing to the beach house. It's Oreo. Oh my gosh, it's Oreos in the middle. Cookie dough on the bottom, brownies on the top, and I'm about to drool all over my camera because it's that delicious. And then I just always like to add strawberries whenever I eat something decadent. One, it makes me feel like, meh, okay, it's semi, like it's not as bad for me because I'm eating some natural sugar too. Then I also, it's just delicious, so that's what I do. Try it out, maybe you'll like it too. I grabbed some of these just for the kids to munch on, their yogurt covered pretzels, grabbed some fresh dill. Don't really remember why. I'm sure it's for a marinade. I was jotting down all the ingredients real quick. And I love zucchini on the grill. So I grabbed some zucchini to cook on the grill when we're at the beach house. It's just a quick, easy side dish vegetable. Three mangoes. I have two in the fridge that are ready to cut. And I think these are ready to cut too, so they'll be nice. Just for a snack for the kids. And then pretzels for a snack. I grabbed this Chipotle Gourmets. Oh, do you see that? Gourmets. I normally buy a Sir Kensington from Thrive Market, but they've been out of it for, I don't know, last couple times I've ordered. So I picked this up. Plus, I don't want to bring my whole jar of mayonnaise to the beach house when I go to make sandwiches. And that's like a two-in-one. It's mayonnaise and a flavor, you know. The less things I can bring to the beach house, the better. I also grabbed some Olive Garden dressing. I'm out of dressing. This is for the salads and some marinades. Ooh, some good ones too. Sweet chili sauce, Coco Aminos. I use this in lieu of soy sauce. It's just a soy-free alternative. And I think it actually tastes a lot better. It's better for you also. So it's a little bit more expensive, but like how much is your health cost? Something like that, right? I grabbed a container or a can of crushed tomatoes. I also plan on making chilies. I wasn't sure chilies. I mean, chili. You guys know chili. I don't know if I have any beans. I know Avelina likes to eat them. I know I have black beans. Well, I say I know I have black beans. I think I have black beans and then also some red kidney beans. We're gonna make some hamburgers and hot dogs on the grill at the beach house. It's just like so easy. You know what I mean? Cook outside so the inside doesn't get hot. I also grabbed some lunch meat for the sandwiches we're going to make. Publix Deli is the best when it comes to, I don't know, everything. Oh, you know what I hid from the kids? I hid it up here with my plants. Look at these delicious beauties. They are chocolate chip muffins and they were buy one, get one free. I love when Publix does this. I almost thought, oh, let me whip my own together, but these just taste so much better. I think they taste better because I didn't have to make them. You know what I mean? Like food always tastes better when someone else makes it for you. They'll eat these this morning. So I don't have to make them breakfast and then meal prep all the food. So it's just a quick breakfast idea. And then I grabbed these for mostly Avelina, but everyone really eats them. They're hot buffalo wing pretzels. Oh my gosh, they are addictive. I grabbed some pepper jack cheese for the Sammies that we want to make. Publix, did I say Publix Deli? Publix Bakery is where it's at. They make the best stuff. Salami and ham are the lunch meats of choice. I also grabbed some ground beef. This was the most affordable option. I want to say it was $12 for 3 pounds. I mean, it's not Costco. What can you do? And I thought, well, if I meal prep chili, then I need some of this because I'm out of it. And I couldn't find ground turkey. And I don't know. It was just a mess. I used to buy ground turkey from Publix all the time in the freezer section in a roll like this, but I can never find it. Grab some sausage and I grab some chicken. I have some from Costco. I should have bought more last time I went, but I didn't. So I'm stuck paying primo Publix prices over here. These are frozen chicken breasts, so hopefully they taste okay. I grabbed some hamburger buns, probably some hot dog buns over here. You guys saw this Stash. These are so good. Toasted chips, they're sour cream and onion. Ooh, so much flavor, so much deliciousness. I grabbed some of these, they're multigrain crackers. I don't know, we just like to eat them up. And then every year we go to the beach house, I tell my kids that they're allowed to pick out one box of cereal each, any kind, I won't say no. It's like their beach house treat. So this year they picked Lucky Charms and Fruit Loops. So there's their sugar in the morning. There's sugar for the day, really. Yeah, so there's that. There's my grocery haul.
And that's everything. Thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out. Maybe I'll share with you some clips of when I make the dinners. Maybe, you know, we're gonna go to the beach house right now together, and maybe I'll share some clips of that with you. I feel like I've been meal prepping for 5 hours. But this looks like a nice set of healthy, delicious foods. I'm really happy about the marinades. That's it. Thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out. If you want to subscribe, put a little happy in your day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Daydreams are made of these. Who am I to disagree?